Fellow Spartans, welcome back to part 3 of the Medieval 2 Let's Play on the Stainless Steel 6.4 mod with the English. So we have pushed on and we've taken Carnarvon and we've done that rather well. Took down that rebellion down in the south in Winchester with Gregory, good old Gregory. So now we have to carry on our conquest of Great Britain. Obviously, yeah, the long-term goal, as I said to you last time, will be to push on against the French, but that will be with substantial forces when I have got that done after taking on the Scots in the north and the Irish rebels to the west. So that will happen once we've taken the English, or taken Great Britain for the English, and then we will push on. And hopefully that won't be, you know, when they've got a lot stronger. Hopefully we'll still be doing that when they are developing their faction, the French, but we'll have to fight them with a lot stronger armies than we've got here at Rennes and Caen at the moment. But we'll continue where we're going. We're doing okay, we're doing well. Obviously it's good to be back with this Let's Play series. I'm glad you're happy with it. Episode 2 was out last week, which was received with good news and great joy from all of you, so good to be back with it. This Exeter, this town is pretty much on the outskirts now. It could be used as a feeder to the north of France, but to be honest with you, we'll go for the Brussels. I don't really see Exeter as a point of having to do anything with it, bar try and make money for us. I think that's the only real thing we can use that city for, to be honest with you. This obviously is the main army we've got going at the moment, which is now without a leader. So we'll have to move that out of Carnarvon. I know it's probably suicidal we're doing that, but I'm going to recruit some peasants and archers just to try and hold the garrison down. We will put public gallows there just to try and give us public order bonuses. And obviously then, once we've got them to York, we'll get Duke Robert to lead the men north into Edinburgh from there. So, we've got so much money. Got more money than I know what to do with at the moment. It's a great position to be in. A stonemason. I don't need a stonemason's hut, do I? God. Why want a stonemason hut? I'm like Legend of Total War there. Stonemason hut. We don't need them early game. Construction cost decrease for stone buildings. Well, we can put it elsewhere. We need communal farming still at some point. Gives us a few production we need. Gets the population growth going. But we'll go for military. We'll go for knights stables there. Logging camp. Cost decrease for wooden buildings. Again, not really needed. Brothel, not really needed. Ballista maker. Yeah, we'll definitely need that for our push north. No, we don't need them. Don't need them. Oh, where are they? I'm sure I saw something in London then. Yeah. Archer militia. No, okay. We do need to start building up armies in the south for our advancements in France, so maybe we should start to recruit actually at some point. Bring that tax rate just down a little bit. No, actually, no, not in London. But in, oh no, that's a castle, we can't change. It's got to be stay at normal, hasn't it? Just making sure everything has got buildings being constructed. And they have. So, and the turn, I think. No, let's just recruit. No, we won't recruit there then. No point there, but we're recruiting London. Great, okay. Now, I know obviously very high tax rate does slow down the population growth, but we can get as much as we can income. I mean, to be honest with the income's not a problem, so maybe I may decrease the tax rate down in London a little bit to get the public growth going a little bit more, the population being boosted up. More baby making going on in the capital. Aye. Kingdom of Norway, Kingdom of Leon. The rebels, what are they doing? Nothing. I hate that candidate for adoption spam. Oh, another family member, Miles. Oh, it's Duke Robert's had a son. Unfortunately, the royal bloodline will not be going down to you, Miles, as it is be going down to our king's line here, and it is going to be going to Simond when he comes of age in another 10 years' time. Kingdom of Aragon and Portugal, okay. God, the money again, back up to plus 20,000. As you wish. March to yes, noble sire. Right. Your will, sire. And oh no, we can only move Duke Robert across. We can't use that spearman across.
Assembling a mighty host of your troops, sire.
I mean, to be honest with you, they are slightly down in on their numbers, but the strength of them is quite good. So we can definitely advance into Scotland with that army. Bring them back to York. Oh, Scottish merchant, is it? Let's try and buy him off. Shall we take them, oh no. 17% is not our best odds of beating them there, so we'll leave them. The thing I'm not understanding very well, and it's probably because I haven't played it for such a while, is the retraining thing. I don't know if I've asked this already, but could you just tell me, guys, in the comments below about why is it I can't retrain these troops? It's because I haven't got the buildings to redo them and retrain them at. Is that why? Or is it because of populations, right, things like that? Just tell me just pretty quickly in the comments below, just so I know going forward. But I think it's because of the buildings, but if I'm wrong, then say do tell me. Okay, everything's been built nicely. Gonna recruit another priest actually, just try and get him to build him up into Duke of Exeter now. Well done, Gregory. Congratulations, my friend. Oh no, he's already been Exeter because of down here. Maybe we'll get the Duke of Winchester as well now. But yes. Yeah, get a priest going because then we can try and get him to better himself with his skills. To try and replace our bishop, who will pass soon into the afterlife, if he doesn't become the Pope, that is. Obviously, when he becomes a Pope, he won't become, immortal. But I'm just saying, obviously, something's going to happen to the bishop at one point. And speaking of the bishop, where is he? I need to find him in a minute. Splitting forces, sire. Oh, the Holy Roman Emperor is dead. Oh, another family member, I was going to say. Oh, no, Duke Robert's died. Oh, for God's sake. Every time we have a leader in this army, he fluffs it. Right, let's bring him across. Probably shouldn't have done that, but never mind. Just lower the attach rate for one turn. We get that garrison unit in there. Right, so what does that situation with this then? Okay. So there's actually now, at the moment, no faction heir whatsoever. With Duke Robert dying. So hopefully we can pass it on to Simon now without any problems, I hope. Else we'll be in trouble. But King Henry shouldn't. God, I hope he doesn't die. Else we will have a problem. And of course, the Holy Roman Emperor is dead. So the whole of the Empire, in the east is in mourning. Right, where is the... Oh, our king's down in London. That's fine then. Okay, as long as he's nice and safe and sound in his, on his throne in London, that's fine by me. Right, so we should be able to attack Edinburgh next turn.
My lord.
I want to see if... Can I buy him off? 25% now. I'll see if we can buy him off. Oh, wonderful. Pop away. Yeah, I think it's because I haven't got the buildings of that nature to be able to recruit them there, or retrain them there, I think. But as I say, just confirm it for me if you would, guys. You know, I rely on you to help me along at the best of times. Right, we can get some garrison now at Exeter, which would help with the public order. What's our biggest actual bringer of money at the moment? We've been 25,000 now. What is it? If it's King's Purse, taxes, trade, farming. It's farming, yeah. We'd be boosted up to farming so much. And the trade, it's really starting to reap the benefits of it now. Our farming system in the country is doing very well. Which, of course, is quite, you know... But the word is now realistic. There we go. Thinking about that one for a second, that was a bit of a difficult one. Yeah, quite realistic, obviously, because a lot of agricultural lands in England at that time, a lot of fields across the country. So, you know, why not have that in this game with the land being very fertile and the farming industry booming in the country, which it, of course, definitely is. Look at that, 33,000 now. It's bringing in the money very well. Okay, let's push into Edinburgh now. Here we go, let's attack them. A couple of rams, and again, I'll just keep them at rams at the moment because I don't think we need ladders and siege towers for the moment. Right, let's try and buy off this merchant now. 32%. Oh, flipping heck. Well, that was, rather poor, wasn't it? Ooh, Havilahs, lovely. Definitely recruit them for our invasion of France. Oh, no. Convert the settlement. Oh, yes, that reminds me. I think people wanted me to convert Rennes. A lot of shout-outs for the Rennes to be converted. So let's do that now. Convert that to a castle next. No, in fact, we'll do that now. That will make them make us be able to retrain those forces. I think because I said, obviously, with them being on the border and the fact that we're going to be attacking France... straight off from obviously here, that we need to probably have Rennes as a castle. So people in the comments said to do that. No, we'll go for a high tax rate in York. Okay. Oh right, no buildings in London or Bakehouse. Public order bonus due to happiness and public growth bonus. Yeah, it's got its pluses out of. You know, I'll go for that. Get some more public growth going in London. In our capital. Again, Exeter's a really sort of out of the way city and I'm not really concerned about it at the moment. Really not. Get the land flying again. Flowing, I should say, in Carnarvon. Build some more farming complexes there. Good, we can retrain them. Let's get everything ready now. Just got to start to build up the forces as we need to. Is that priest being trained yet? No? Okay, I'm sure I try to recruit him. Last turn. Oh, agent, here we go. Here he is.
Yes, Majesty.
I thought I was going to train you. So there you go. Here he is. Howard Fleming. What a lovely English name. And where is our bishop? He's down here. On my way.
Yes,
right,
my lord.
Okay. Lawrence Cromnett, yes, bring sire. Him over here.
Without question, sire.
Ooh, rebel stopping settlement here. Sire. The Brigadian rebels. Okay, let's end it once more, and then we can get this Battle of Scotland, or this Siege of Edinburgh, underway. Not the moment, but I tell you what, if it goes, the Doge of Genoa is dead, right? If it carries on with this problems we've got with the factions, with no heirs. Oh, hello. Who are you? Where did you come from? Right. You just appeared from nowhere. You sort of got some sort of some long lost line to the throne or something. Okay. Interesting. Don't know where you've come from. You a cousin of someone's twice removed or something. There's some claim to the English throne from some bizarre line. God knows, but we'll be removing him anyway from the heir once
sire.
Our young prince comes of age.
Then, sire.
So we'll fight Edinburgh now. We'll take this city and rid them from
yes,
their lands.
Sir. We bring the battle to the enemy.
I mean, I suppose obviously having that faction heir who's come to of age now at 14 is good. Where he's come from, I do not know, but it's good to have him there actually, because we need to make sure that nothing happens to the English line of kings. Obviously, King Henry's on the throne; he's sitting comfortably in London, so we shouldn't have a problem. But at the same time, we need to make sure it is secure until Simond is ready to accept his title. Right, Rams, get the Rams ready. Where's the other one? Of course, we won't be having the archers on the Rams. Yeah, Spearmen, you can go on. In fact, no, let's use our Wicked units, or our most heavily damage units in terms of numbers. They're the two weakest, no, they're not. Actually, this one is. The 72, this one. So they are the least numbered units in the army. I can't get my words out tonight. I think I'm a bit tired tonight, guys, actually. Oh, my mouse has gone funny. Hang on. When it does that, I have to blow it, because for some reason I think a bit of dust gets in the laser underneath, you see, and it makes it go all funny. So, bit of a blow, and it's all red again. Yeah, apologies, guys, if this my commentary isn't as good tonight. So I've had a bit of a bad night's sleep last night. So it's probably coming through a bit today. With having kids and whatnot, it's not plain sailing at bedtime. Well, I've been a cavalry to get themselves ready. No, you never know. This Captain Jacob today again proved himself in the field of battle, and he could be a new general coming of not coming of age, but man of the hour sort of thing, you know. Surprised with it. I mean, yeah, we need to start moving that second ram in. And someone said probably try and break a hole at 2 points in the wall, but I don't think I can I? Because they only seem to do it at the actual gate itself and not the actual wall. So that's why I need ballista. So we can get 2 choke points in the wall. Makes it easier to try and take the city. But when you're just trying to cram through that one door, it's not ideal really. Right, archers, go for those on the wall there, those spear militia. How much damage has the ram got? No, it's 0%, that's excellent. Archers are starting to fire. Not really making an impact yet. To be honest with you, I think it may be better if we get all the archers to hit these, because they are our main problem. They are standing there ready to face us when the ram destroys the gate, so let's try and bring them down.
Our men have reached the gate with a battering ram.
We know that. Come on, ram, ram, ram. Ram like you've never rammed before, ram. Come on. Obviously, these have got a lot more range on in these archer militia than the standard levy archers. So if we can, we'll start to recruit them more than we do with the levy archers. I think we'll try and go for archer militia going forward. Obviously, long term, we want longbowmen. The might of the longbow units in the English army is always what we want, so definitely go for them when we can get them. I think they're a recruitable unit in Wales, actually, so we'll try and go for them at Carnarvon. The gate pushing through yet? 30%, right, okay. Aren't we making an impact yet, are we? I think it's because obviously our angle of trajectory of these arrows is not making an impact on them. We're going down quite softly into the ground, so they're not really making an impact on the men. It's not good. So we'll go for these guys on the wall, see if we can try and whittle these down instead. We're raining the arrows down on them, but it's not to... We've taken one man down. That's it. Right, come on, get these guys here. Again, not really making an impact on them yet. I think, you know, we'll see the fight, you know, the real might of these archers when we're in open battles, possibly. The archer militia at the back are getting a better angle at them. Let's just fast forward, actually, while we're waiting. Right, we need you there now, guys. Let's rush the gates. And I'm going to rush him with my cavalry. Call me a bit mad, but I'm going for the cavalry charge here. Let's start these.
Now is the time for brave right, come on. And brave
I'm going to open up proceedings with a siege. With a cavalry charge. Come on, come on, come on. Let's go for it. And then we'll push in afterwards with our spear. Okay, here we go. We're still raining down upon them. Taking a few of them down, but not many. Okay, this should send them flying, this spear militia. They shouldn't be able to withstand this heavy cavalry charge. Okay, here we go. That sent them completely fleeing for their lives. So they're going to try and push back to the town centre now.
Our soldiers have proved their worth. The battle is very much in
okay,
our
favour. Good stuff, good stuff, good stuff, good stuff.
Victory will be ours.
That's it, mow them down, mow them down. Right, spear now, you go in to protect and support. Nice horses, some of these must be big Shire horses. Which of course it would have to be, wouldn't it, to be able to support the heavy armoured units, basically. Big Shire horses also being at the time. Really imposing figures on the battlefield, most definitely. Can you imagine one of them trying to come down upon you? It'd be horrendous. And I've seen Shire horses in real life. They are big horses, very big horses. Right, let's pull off the cavalry charge. Because I want to try and get the spears in now to engage. We'll try and flank around with our cavalry now. Okay, spearmen, get in there. It's your turn now. Oh. Didn't realise we've got these at the gates. Right, we'll go for the side charge. Now we've got the spear engaged with them. Pinning them down, we'll go for a charge at the side with the cavalry. Come on then, go for it, go for it, go for it. Ah, they are wavering, excellent. Right, archers, I think you need to cease fire now.
Badly bloodied. They have lost half their men.
Right, taking off fire at will.
The battle is very much in our favour. If we remain true,
fire at will? Which ones will?
Will be ours.
They're a good old joke. Right, okay, pushing on now. Ah, they're even wavering already at the side of that charge of all our spear units coming forward. Awesome. Let's bring across the cavalry now to go around the back here. Alright, keep pushing. Oh, hello, we've got our general's bodyguard here. The heavy cav. Right, if we take them down, we've got this one in the bag. Right, let's push him forward. It's nice, these guys, these can relax. We don't really need them. However, we will need the archers probably to try and take out the general's bodyguard. A lot of noise here. A lot of clashing of armour there. Right, let's drag him in. Right, cavalry, where are you? You're around here. I've got to take that arrow mod off because I think it's making this a little bit too laggy now, this game. Got to do that next time before I start up episode 4. Great mod, the fact you can have them all on the battlefield, all the arrows that remain, but you know, all the hours to stay there, but at the same time it does half make this game a lot laggier now because they have fired a bloody shed load of arrows on the floor. Makes it a lot more realistic, but at the same time does have an effect. Right, here we go, Cav, come on, charge me in the back. Charge! That's it, mown down! The general's bodyguard have engaged, but they're against our speed. Oh my god, he sent two of them wavering already. That is not good. Right. Spear militia, get in there. Sorry guys, I thought I was going to be able to leave you alone and not have to fight this battle, but yeah, I kind of need you now. Whoever is that trumpeter needs to be sacked. It's an horrendous horn. Right, we're surrounding them now. Surely this should be it now. We've got him pinned down in the centre on both sides. We're raining death from above.
The battle is very much in our favour. If we remain true and steadfast, victory will be ours.
Spear militia, get yourselves in there. Thing with this game, you have to drag them through past the enemy, and then when they're sort of intermingled in with the enemy, you can then drag them into to fight them. It's a bit of a problem with this game sometimes. Unfortunately, the charge was a bit suspect. Don't worry. Right, now go for it. That's it. Got him pinned seriously now. There's only five of them left. All credit to the Scots, though. They're fighting for every inch of their lives, but it's all over. They know they should be beaten now. Come on, spearmen. One man left. The captain of Scotland's garrison force at Edinburgh is now to fall. Look at him, he's putting one hell of a fight up. Full credit to him. God, he's taking a lot of hits. He's got a number of hit points. Oh, the enemy king! Guys, he's a captain! Yes! No wonder he fought forever. No wonder he kept fighting. The King of Scotland is dead. King Ectar. Is it Edgar? King Edgar. Edgar, yeah. E-T-G-A-R. Edgar, yeah, I'll go for that one. God, the King of Scotland. If I'd known that, wow. No wonder he fought for every inch of his land. King of Scotland is dead. So let's occupy. We don't need the money. We do not need the money. Captain Jacob. Lovely. Well, well, well. There must be another king, obviously, in Inverness up here. has taken the throne of Scotland now, but they are in serious trouble now. The English are at their gates. We've pushed into Edinburgh, taken that. We'll go further north, and then we'll carry on into Ireland, in the Irish rebels' town there. So, ladies and gentlemen, I shall wrap it up here for part 3. I hope you've enjoyed it. We have made more progress, as we always will on these Let's Plays. I'm sure every episode we will gain more and more ground. The enemy king, the King of Scotland, has died. We have been victorious in Edinburgh, and we have now got to make sure our line of kings is secure for the centuries to come. So make sure that hopefully Prince Simon will come of age very soon. But as always, guys, thanks for watching. If you've enjoyed part 3, drop a like. I'll be back very soon with the 4th part, as I always am. But please remember to comment and subscribe. Put me up on Facebook, Twitter, and the Steam group, The Heroes of Sparta. But until next time, the victorious English King is saying farewell.